Hello everyone, in this lesson we're going to look at the process to disable the Microsoft Defender Antivirus permanently on Windows 11. It is important to know that running an operating system without an antivirus is not recommended, but there could be times when you might want to do this. For example, on a device that does not connect to the network or security isn't unconcerned to you. This lesson is not meant to be used as an instructional video. Instead, this is an educational video that shows you that it's possible to disable the antivirus on Windows 11. Also, you should note that installing another antivirus on Windows 11 will disable Microsoft Defender automatically. You can even disable the antivirus temporarily through the Windows Security app. However, if you insist in disabling the default antivirus on your computer, you can use these steps. Before proceeding, it is important to know that this process requires modifying the registry, so it is always recommended to create a backup before proceeding. Okay, to disable Microsoft Defender Antivirus permanently on Windows 11, first open Start and look for the Windows Security app. Then we're gonna go to the Virus and Threat Protection settings, and then we're gonna click on Manage Settings. On this page, we're gonna turn off the tamper protection feature. We are doing this because if you don't turn off the tamper protection, the registry modifications won't take effect to disable the antivirus. Close the Windows Security app. Now open Start and look for the registry. In here, we're going to navigate to the Windows Defender key, which is located under HKey Local Machine Software Policies Microsoft. Select the Windows Defender key, right click on it, select New, and choose the DWORD option. Then we're going to name this DWORD Disable Anti-Spyware and press Enter. Right click on it, select Modify, and set it to 1. Now we're going to create another DWORD, and in this case we're going to name it Disable Real-Time Monitoring. And then we're going to modify it and set it to 1. Then we're going to create another DWORD, and this time we're going to name it Disable Antivirus and press Enter. We're going to modify it and we're going to set the value to 1. One more time, we're going to right click the Windows Defender key, we're going to select New, and we're going to choose the DWORD option. And then we're going to name it Disable Spatial Running Mode and press Enter. Then we're going to right click on it, select the modify option, and set the value to 1. One more time, we're going to right click the Windows Defender key, and then we're going to choose the DWORD option, and we're going to name it Disable Routinely Taking Action and press Enter. Then we're going to modify it and set the value to 1. One more time, we're going to create another DWORD, and we're going to name it Service Keep Alive and press Enter. And we're going to change the value and set it to 1. Now we're going to right click the Windows Defender key, but we're going to create another key, and we're going to name it Real-Time-Space-Protection and press Enter. Now we're going to right click the newly created key, and we're going to create a DWORD, and then we're going to name it Disable Behavior Monitoring and press Enter. We're going to modify it and set the value to 1. Going to right click the key again, and we're going to create another DWORD, but this time we're going to name it Disable On Access Protection and press Enter. Then we're going to modify it and we're going to set it to 1. We need to create a few more, so we're going to right click on it, select the DWORD option, and then we're going to name it Disable Real-Time Monitoring, and we're going to set this value to 1. We're going to create yet another DWORD, and this time we're going to name it Disable Scan On Real-Time Enable and press Enter. Then we're going to modify it and set the value to 1. Now we're going to right click the Windows Defender key, and we're going to create another subkey, and this time we're going to name it Signature Space Updates. Then we're going to right click the newly created key, and then we're going to create another DWORD, and this time we're going to name it Force Update From MU and press Enter. Then we're going to modify the DWORD, and we're going to set the value to 1. Now right click the Windows Defender key, select New and choose Key, and then we're going to name this key SpyNet and press enter. Then we're going to right click the newly created key, set new, and we're going to choose the DWORD option. And this time we're going to name it disable blocked at first seen and press enter. Then we're going to modify the value and we're going to set it to 1. And those are the changes that you need to make to the registry to disable the Microsoft Defender antivirus. And now to apply the changes, we need to restart the computer. After restarting the computer, you can check that the antivirus is now disabled by opening and start and looking for the Windows Security app. Then we go to Virus and Threat Protection, and now we can see that the antivirus is no longer enabled on the computer. And now the antivirus will remain disabled until you remove the settings. So that means that after restarting the computer, the antivirus will continue to be disabled on the system. Now, if you want to undo the changes and re-enable Microsoft Defender, do this. Open Start and look for the registry. Navigate to the path where all the settings were changed. In this case, H key, local machine, software policies, Microsoft, Windows Defender. In here, we're going to select all the DWORDs that were created, right click, and select the delete option. Then there is also the real-time protection key and all the DWORDs. You can simply right click the real-time protection key and select the delete option. There is also the signature updates key with this option right here. You can also right click on that specific key and click and choose the delete option. And finally, there is the SpyNet key with the disable blocked at first seen DWORD. So basically you just need to right click on the key, select delete, and that will undo all the changes previously applied to disable the antivirus. Then close the application. We're going to open the Windows Security app, and then we're gonna go to Virus and Threat Protection, then open the Manage Settings page and turn on Tamper Protection. Restart the device, and that will re-enable the antivirus. Now to confirm that the antivirus is working, open Start and look for the Windows Security app. And as you can see, we got a green check, but we can go to the Virus and Threat Protection setting and we can see that the protection is enabled on the computer. And on the shield for the system tray, we can see that we have a green check, meaning that everything is working. And that is all there is to it. That's how you permanently disable the Microsoft Defender antivirus on Windows 11 and how you can undo the changes to re-enable the security feature. Remember to like the video, leave your comments, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done that yet, and I just hope this video was informative for you, and I would like to thank you for viewing.